Ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be a quick tutorial on how to use virtual audio cable in conjunction with Flash Media Encoder. This will also help out people who want to rip music off of Audacity, but we're just going to mainly focus on using virtual audio cable with FME. So without further ado, we're going to get things started. I'm going to assume that you all have virtual audio cable installed into your computer. It's very easy to install. But if you're using a 64-bit operating system, keep in mind, make sure that you are installing version 4.10. This is the latest version as of July 2010. If you are using a 64-bit OS and you are using a driver that is of an earlier version, you are going to run into a few installation complications. You will have to set your operating system into a test mode and then install it from there. It's a little bit funky. I don't go down that route. Just get this driver version if you're using 64-bit. Otherwise, if you're a 32-bit user, you will have no problems with any of the driver versions. They all pretty much work great. I've tested out 4.06. That works beautifully, and I'm pretty damn sure that the rest of the other versions work just as great. You don't have to fiddle with anything with the control panel here. Just one cable, that's all we need, and we're going to see this later in our sound devices. And with that being said, later will be now. We're going to go down to our task pane here. We're going to right click on the little speaker, and here you'll have a few options. Just click on any one of these three because they all lead to the same window. You will notice that under both playback and recording that line one is the common factor here. This tutorial is also here to help people who do not have stereo mix, if you want to find means to stream stuff, right? So usually we have our main output source, aka headphones or speakers, set to default. This will not be the case. Line 1 will be set as our default this time if you want to stream sound. And if you set this as your default, you might question with how are you able to hear your sounds if your sound signals are not getting sent to your headphones? Because what's happening is, if you're setting your line 1 as your default, then you're telling your computer to send all the sound signals coming from your video games or your media streaming from VLC or Windows Media Player, things coming out of your computer, your stereo mix signals. You're telling the computer to send it all down line 1 and not through your headphones. Well, there's a very, very quick fix for that. Go under recording and just basically do the same thing. Set your line 1 as your default. Go down to properties. And then you have the listen tab. Just keep in mind that you will not get the listen tab if you go under playback and hit properties on line 1. Listen tab will not work. Make sure you're under recording and you will get this tab. Next thing, you will see this diagram. Just to simply put, this is your input device. And because we're in line 1 properties, this is our main input. And you can see the arrow leading to our output, aka my speakers. To enable this function, just check this, listen to this device, and then use the pull down box, pick out your main audio device that you want to send sound signals through, and pick it, click OK, and you're good to go. Now you're literally able to stream sound. And if you set your line 1 as your default in FME, then everything will go according to plan. As you will see, just give it a quick moment, there we go. And you will see, just like in my last tutorial, under audio device, we have line 1 set as our main device. So once you start playing your media, I'm going to actually show you guys that. Go back to that TV show Shadow Raiders, because I think it is very underrated. There we go. So if I go back to FME, see? I'm going to stop talking for just like a quick moment. You will see the green bars go up and down. See, the video is playing and we're hearing sound. So yeah, there you go. That's how to stream sound. That's basically it. If you guys fancy yourselves to in-game commentaries, or you just like to talk over whatever you're streaming, then use the same principles. You highlight microphone, go to properties, Listen tab, make sure you're under recording, and then you'll see the input and your output. Again, just check this box. I'm not going to check it now, but you will if you want to do that sort of thing. And then just pick your output. And here we want to stream our voice through line one. And then you just hit OK, and your voice will get heard to the public and the masses. That's literally it. I mean, aside from that, you can just adjust the levels according to how loud your voice should be over your music or sounds, things like that. If you people are using Windows XP, then there are thousands of tutorials on how to use Stereo Mix. I mean, here's a very quick image. I mean, if you're using Windows XP, then you should be familiar with this window. It's called Recording Control. Again, it's just like here. I'm going to go back to recording devices. It's just like this window I have here in Windows 7. Okay, so here I have line 1 set as my default. And under recording controls, Windows XP has something called Stereo Mix. Okay, now under Windows Vista and Windows 7, not many people have Stereo Mix listed as their recording or playback device, as you will see. Okay, now in this person's case, this is just an image, but in this person's case, they have checked off this option as well as this option to reveal Stereo Mix. So if you guys want to see if you do have Stereo Mix installed into your computer, if you're using an OS like Vista or 7, then check these two boxes and see if you have Stereo Mix. But as you will see under mine, I do not have that. Just a bunch of microphones, digital audio, more microphones, and whatever the hell this is. That's all I have. I don't have a Stereo Mix under recording as this person does. So that's why I have to use virtual audio cable. If you are using, going back to Windows XP, your voice, if you want to do in-game commentary again on Windows XP, then make sure your microphone has this sort of plug. Because if you do have this kind of plug, then you do not need to use virtual audio cable at all. Your voice signals will go through Stereo Mix, no problem. All you have to do is just go back to master volume, which is a different volume pane with a bunch of channel strips just like this, but it's not the same. This is output. I mean, this is not output. This is input, and master volume or volume controls is output. And then you select there's a microphone channel strip, and you can change the levels however you see fit, and just make sure it fits your stream. Adjust it that way. And that's pretty much it. Oh, I forgot to mention. One person commented saying that they didn't have the Listen tab under Windows Vista. So what you need to do is go to Virtual Audio Cable. And you will see Audio Repeater. Again, if you have this installed, then you should have Audio Repeaters. And then it just works the same way. Wave in, wave out. This is your input, this is your output. So for example, if you want to send your voice, okay, that's your input, through to cable one. Well, that's it. Just your microphone input, output is your cable one. Then you just hit start and it'll work, no problem. And then you could stop it whenever you want. Works the exact same way as the Listen tab. That concludes this tutorial. Again, comments, questions, criticisms, post them below. Otherwise, I will see you guys next time. Have fun streaming. Godspeed, and eat a lot of beef.